time. And one of the popular stories that we can hear at summer is scary stories related to ghosts. But do you guys really believe that ghosts exist? How many of you think that ghosts exist? Okay, not many people. Now, I don't want to force you to believe that ghosts exist, nor that ghosts do not exist. But in my case, I used to think that such a thing as a ghost is the rubbish until I had an extraordinary experience when I was 15 years old. I was studying for the entrance exam to go to foreign language high school at Academy with my friends. We had classes till 10 p.m. and after the class, from 10 to 2 a.m., we had to head to the prep, which is studying by yourself. One day, I really wanted to have some fresh air, but students weren't allowed to get out of the building because, you know, teachers wanted to keep the students under control. But we could go to the rooftop if we got the permission from the teachers or guards, and at least more than two people should go together to prevent the unfortunate accident. Since I was a good boy, I didn't bother to get the permission from the teachers, and I didn't want to disturb my friends, so I sneaked out of the classroom and took the elevator. I took the elevator by myself, and as I reached the sixth floor, it suddenly stopped with a jerk. I was a little bit scared, so I kept pressing the open button. But it didn't got open. I mean, it did open, but it opened after a few minutes or so. I was fortunate to get escape from the elevator, and I had two choices from there: going up to the rooftop as I planned, or going back to the classroom. And I chose the latter because something kept me from going up to the rooftop. I decided not to take the elevator, so instead, I used the staircase to go down. But since it was in the middle of the night, everything was in dark, and even emergency lights were off. So I had no choice but to go down the staircase very slowly. In absolute darkness, except your vision, all your senses get very sensitive. And would this be the reason? As I got closer to the fourth floor, I started to hear a sound. The sound of water, like. I wanted to find out where the sound came from. And as I got closer to the restroom at fourth floor, the sound got louder and louder. Now maybe someone had forgotten to turn off the faucet, so I went into the restroom to check the faucet. But there was nothing wrong. And as I checked the faucet, that water dropping sound stopped. Instead, I started to hear another sound. A girl. Even worse, the sound was coming from my back, and it was getting closer and louder every sentence. However, I decided to gather all my courage to face whatever was behind me, because without it, I thought I would never be able to go back to the classroom. So I slowly turned my back to see what was behind me. And as I turned my back, I was attacked
by the flashlight. The guard of the building was standing there. He yelled at me,
"What the hell are you doing here?" Of course, I freaked and panicked. I yelled him back. But thanks to him, I was able to go back to the classroom safe and sound. Now, if the story ends from here, I probably have thought that it was just my hallucination or I misheard something. But there are some few evidences that made me feel that the experience that I had is very unusual and abnormal. First, the power of the building wasn't out at that day. And all the restrooms in that building had the automatic sensors. So if you go into the restroom, the lights should have been turned off, but it didn't. And I had an experiment
with my friend after that day, and we checked whether the lights would turn on or not. But all the class, all the floors, including that fourth floor, all the restrooms, lights got turned on. Secondly, I asked the guard, how did you find me? And he asked me back, did you hear that water dropping sound and someone saw it? Because he heard it too, and that's how he guessed that I might be in that restroom. Third, this is just a rumor, but about 4 or 5 years ago, while the building was built, at that construction site, a girl got died because of the accident. And there was a rumor that there's a her ghost was like living near that building. And finally, there's no boys' restroom in that room. There's no boys' restroom in that fourth floor. So I was in the girls' restroom. I didn't realize that. Dark. I was focused with that water drop. But after that day, I figured out that there's no boys' restroom. Now, I'm not telling you guys to believe the stories that I just told you. Now, of course, I'm a person who can read the technical papers to give speeches in front of you, but I swear I did not make this story up to give speeches in front of you. Of course, it depends on you whether you believe it or not. This is the story that I got to believe that some kind of extraordinary existence would live in this world. Oh, I'm so scared. I should still be.